Welcome along to another Biggles video. In this one, we're taking a trip down to Kent to see where this stuff's made, Shepherd Neame. So we'll be going to Faversham. Come on then. Are you coming? Here we are then in the reception centre for Shepherd Neame. This is located in the High Street, Faversham, and they've got their very own pub on the front here, which is the reception centre. And from here, we'll wander through and see what it's like if you turned up as a customer, buyer, seller, whatever. This is the main office reception area. Very nice and old-fashioned looking, like the spiral stairs and the lamps. And this beast awaiting us. Okay, this looks like the place, the brew house. We'll get in here and see exactly what they've got for machinery to churn out those fabulous brews. It's quite noisy in here with all the different machines and storage areas. Lots of nice pipes and machinery buzzing away. Now there's the yeast for the ale stored in that container. Oh, what are these buttons? Let's just press one of these, shall we, and see what happens. Some of the ingredients, the grist, chocolate malt, the different malt flavours, lager malt, and here's some of the mash tuns. Now these mash tuns are interesting because they are stainless steel. They were replaced a few years ago, but the wooden outer parts are the originals from the original old wooden outer, so they put the wooden bits over the new stainless steel. And those wooden outers are over 100 years old. Have a look at these fabulous windows. Apparently they had to knock this wall out when they put these new mash tuns in to lift them in. So when it was rebuilt, they had these fabulous windows put in. Oh my goodness, look, it's 10 to 12. That means it must be time for a drink, surely. These are the containers that the beer and brews are stored in. And here's a quick peek ahead through the window where the boffins work, where they put together all the different ingredients and mixture. Now we're in the museum, and of course that's a Triumph Spitfire. Spitfire is the most popular brew of Shepherd Neame. And this was the old malt house back in the old days. This was used. This building's now used as their social centre. You can actually book it and have a party here. Let's have a look at a few of these old cars. This is a Reliant just coming up here. That looks like part of a fire engine. But it may not be.
Yeah.
Here we have an actual Spitfire body, the cockpit of a Spitfire. Bit of old switch gear. And this is the Cooper's Corner of the museum, where the barrels would have been made by the Cooper, with all the tools on the back wall there. And as we come into the main hall, these are all the signs that were taken down over the years of pubs, Shepherd Neame pubs. This is the main part of the hall where you would have your functions. And as we see, there's an old press there. And the tables are set up. That's the bar. I did actually come to a party here a few years ago. With the live band. It was very nice, very enjoyable. Ah, now here's the best bit. This is the part where we taste the beer.
Particular things that we want to make sure that they know. It's all about this quality, it's all about this good beer that we've been talking about, the consistency. So, what the brewers start off looking for, we call the three C's. So that's colour, clarity and condition. So first thing we're going to do is pick up your number one off your numbered, and then if you'd like to tell me what colour you think it is. Nice answers, please. Honey. Honey. Oh, I love you too. Oh, honey, I'll be your honey. Honey.
Golden.
Golden, yes. After several glasses of water, that sort of thing. Yeah, we know. So lovely, lovely colour. Now, we talked about at the bottom of the hill that the clarity, didn't we? So we should be able to lift up our glass and wiggle our fingers behind. There's a bit of condensation behind it, but you wiggle your glass, you can see your fingers. So that's that lovely multi-barley clarity. Brilliant. Then the condition. Now, how do we check the condition? Our condition is all about these bubbles. So have a look at our bubbles. We've got nice varied size ones. We're going to give our glass a little swirl. This is why they've not been. And you can see how the bubble sticks to the glass and slide down. We call that lacing. And it shows a nice, good condition. Second thing that the brewers need to do. A lot of our brewing is automated these days, but nothing can replace any of us when it comes to the smell and the taste of something. So we start off with the smell. So pop your hand over the top of your glass, give it a little swirl. We're going to release all of those lovely aromas. And then have a sniff and tell me what you think it smells like. Beer is not a good answer. Smell that. Now we're all going to smell and taste these certainly differently. We're all of different ages, different genders. There might be different geographical factors where we've grown up. So a little bit of sip, maybe a little bit lemony, maybe a little bit. What can you smell? I've heard everything from roast chicken to leather handbags, so really nothing will surprise me. So don't hold back if you go, well, I think it smells like this. That's fine. Believe me. Right, shall we get to the next and the final part, most importantly. So the brewers need to taste it. So, ladies and gentlemen, cheers.
Cheers.
So we have number one, which was the 5 grain at 5%. Number two was the Whitstable Bay Blonde, which is 4.5%. Number three was the Master Brew, which was 3.7. The Session Ale, now you know, you can use that all the time now. Oh yeah, that definitely is Session Ale. Number four was the Bishop's Finger, 5%, because it's in a bottle, not from draft. Number five was the 1698 Bottle Conditioned Ale, the one with a little bit of yeast, 6.5%. And finally, the Black Stout, the Whitstable Bay Black Stout at 4.2%. Ladies and gentlemen, this brings us to the end of our tour.
Well, I hope you enjoyed our look round the Shepherd Neame Brewery in Faversham, Kent. Weren't those pub signs interesting? And the old cars. Please like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.